everyone. Good morning or good afternoon, as the case may be. All I know is it's Friday, and we're here for another episode of Triday Friday. We like to come to you here from Spellbinders in Phoenix, Arizona, just about every Friday, just to share some new tips and tricks and techniques. I am Kim Kesty here in the creative classroom at Spellbinders. So welcome. We do want to remind you that you probably saw the little thing flash up on the screen there. We are broadcasting on Facebook and on YouTube, but YouTube is the best place to go. Like our channel, subscribe, even click the notification button so you will never miss a thing. Because like I said, every Friday we have a lot of fun here. And we have some new product releases here at Spellbinders that I'm super excited about. I'm going to be using one of the brand new dies from that release. So let's take a look at what it is. It's all about lemons. Oh my gosh. We were talking in the office earlier this week. This is one of our very favorite dies from the brand new release. The entire release is called Be Bold. So you've got blooms and you've got alphabets and so many other fun things, but this lemon zest really kind of has a little place in my heart. Of course, here in Arizona, we grow a lot of citrus, and lemon trees in particular grow very, very well here in Arizona. So super fun. Again, called Lemon Zest. I'm going to be creating a fun little card with it, and I'll show you just how easy it is to work with. Okay, I've got the, this is actually the die in the packaging here, but I've got one already open. I'm going to pull it out and just show you the fun little pieces. And one thing that really makes this unique is the little leaves. When you die cut the leaves, you're also going to get the opportunity to add this extra little fun shadow. So here's the little group of leaves right here that you can kind of double up on your die cut. Here's the lemons. I'll share those in just a second. But I wanted to show you this. So I've already glued a couple of these pieces on, and I'm going to show you how to glue the last couple. But this leaf is perfectly adorable and super sweet, even without the little highlights. But when you add that highlight by just using two different colors of green cardstock, so here I've got our rainforest and the peridot, which is a little bit brighter and lighter. So I've cut the accents out of the lighter color, the peridot. And then they're kind of like a little, little tanagram, anagram, what are those things called when you kind of fit the pieces in. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to glue it on the bottom of the leaf here. The accents cut out all across the bottom. Whoops, that's the wrong one. All right, Kim, get it right here. This one goes in this little bit chubbier leaf. And then this guy goes on this leaf. So like I said, it's just kind of like fitting the little pieces of the puzzle. It's not something you're required to do in this die, but it sure is cute, isn't it? Just adding that fun little highlight just really makes those leaves super much come to life. So absolutely love that. The lemons are just one piece right here, but I'm going to show you an extra little trick I have to add the little white highlights behind. But before we do that, I'm going to move these dies to the side. I'm going to bring in our stencil mat. This is another new product that we're carrying on the Spellbinders website, which is, of course, spellbinderspaperarts.com. And it's from Awful Flower Crafts. And we just love, when we fall in love with a product, we really want to share it with you and kind of give you our little insider tips and tricks. So we really love the stencil mat. It does have two raised edges here, which is really cool for stenciling. So imagine putting your cardstock here and nestling your stencil inside. It's going to stay sturdy while these two sides are open, so you can have bigger stencils, larger pieces of paper, whatever you're working on. But I also love just this, using this mat all the time for a craft surface. It's silicone, it wipes up super clean. It is perfect for doing some little inking. So I'm actually going to bring in some yellow ink. And I want to do this before I add my white highlights. That's why I'm bringing this in now. And I'm going to bring in some green for my leaves too. So I've just got a couple of our Distress Oxide colors, Mustard Seed and Mowed Lawn. And so all I'm going to do is just come in. I just want to add a little bit of a darker kind of lemony yellow color on the edge of my lemons just to kind of deepen them up. Because I feel like this is the shadow side and this is the side the sun is hitting. So just doing it just like that. And that's exactly how I did my other two. Did those earlier. And then as far as the green, I'm just going to come in and just add a little bit of green to some of these edges. I did a little bit on this side already, so I'll just add some green right in here. So again, just kind of deepening that cardstock, just adding a touch of, you know, blended ink there. So pretty, right? And what a simple way just to really kind of do that next level, bringing your die cuts to life. So again, because this is silicone, I just wanted to share it. It just wipes up super easy. I've got a baby wipe. And virtually nothing sticks to it. So done. You're all set. Ready for your next project. So I thought it'd be kind of fun to share that stencil mat with you. Now we've got our main die cuts, and let me talk about the little white highlight back here. All I did was grab a scrap piece of white cardstock, and I just kind of line my little lemon up here. And you just need enough trimmed off just to kind of capture those little white highlights. So I'm following the edge of the... I'm going a little slower because I'm trying not to cut into my die cut. You don't want to do that. Lose your little lemon shape. But for the back, then you just need a little slice. So I'm just kind of rounding the shape of that back there. Does that make sense? So I'm just doing a little white cardstock. I want to pop these lemons up on my card. If I was going straight to a white card base, for example, pretend this is white, you know, I wouldn't have to do this step. But I'm not putting these on a white card base, as you will see in just a minute. So I did really want to add that extra cardstock to the back. So again, just another little tip about how to kind of change the look of your die cut. Of course, if there's any excess, you could trim it away, but looks like mine fits there pretty good. I have to trim just a little bit right here. Okay, and you can see that that's pretty much just what I did with my other lemons. So there's all their little white highlights ready to go. And there is a little slot in the top of this. I love to grab my tool in one and just kind of go in there and just kind of open up that little slot. This is going to allow me to add in my extra stems. So I've got one stem right here for this lemon, but I'm going to need a couple extra stems for my other two. So speaking of which, you've got an extra stem. You've got two different opportunities to do an extra stem. This is a separate die right here that does have the little kind of blossom top. And you'll see that I went ahead and glued some of those together for some of the lemon blossoms. And then it's also got this little die for the flowers and the little blossom top. So those I've already die cut and kind of put together. But there is also an extra stem here attached to this die cut. Someone might be wondering, oh gosh, why is that there? So I'm going to go ahead and use this piece to cut a couple extra stems. And I'm going to grab some of my best ever craft tape. Because again, I don't need to cut out all these leaves. I just want that one extra little stem. Sometimes we like to attach them to our dies so they don't get lost. That little skinny stem piece might be one that would be easier to lose. Of course, my tape falls off. Go back, stay on there. I'll just keep it right side up. I'm so used to cutting my dies blade side down, I sometimes forget that they cut equally well blade side up. Just something I don't always think about. So we'll pop that little stem out. And I think I'm gonna cut one more. I'm not sure if I'm going to use two, but I'm going to cut it. Be ready just in case. Oops. I guess my best ever craft tape got cut. Let's grab a little bit more. This time I'll tape it to the cutting mat, not the die cut. That way I can reuse my tape. I like that our craft tape, so you can reuse it. I'll pop it right there. The craft tape matches our project today. That's pretty cool. Yellow, yellow. I've got something else that matches my project today too. I'll talk about in a minute. That was not planned, but... Alright, so I've got my two extra little stems there. Like I said, I'm not sure I'm going to use both, but as I assemble my card, we'll kind of go with it and play with it. More extra flowers here. So now we've got some lemons, we've got some leaves. Now we need something to adhere them to, right? So what I went ahead and did was just trimmed a piece of white, cardstock into a rectangle. And then because I love the whole idea of a black and white stripe and kind of a B bold, especially contrasted with the lemons with that beautiful yellow, I thought I'll make my own striped background. I probably showed this maybe about a year ago. I did some striped backgrounds on cards, and it's just a kind of a technique I like to revisit every so often. So this goes on a card front, and it's not like a regular size mat in A2. I trimmed it a little bit smaller, so it's actually a half inch smaller all the way around than my card front. So just to give you an idea of what size I originally cut it. And then I at first did cardstock strips that were 3/4 inch. This is kind of, again, my process. And I put them on originally and I was like, oh no, those just seem too thick, a little bit too bold, right? So I went back and cut them a little bit smaller and narrower. Now I think, looking at this now, I think I could probably even gone a little bit skinnier, but I think this will be fine. So just a fun idea. If you don't always have pattern paper exactly how you want it, stripes are certainly an easy thing to recreate on your own. And you can see I'm just trimming my cardstock by flipping it over, and then I can get a nice even edge. Trim this one up a little bit more. Yeah, and then your stripes come out really cute. So I do want Roy to flip to a shot of the front of me. Oh, there you can see the shirt. So this I did not plan. I did not plan on having a black and white striped card front and a black and white striped shirt today, but you know, serendipity. Sometimes these things work out. So I'm going to go ahead and pop this up on my card front. I'm going to do this first, so then when I adhere my lemons, they can kind of, the stems can hang out over the edge of this panel. So I'm just using some foam squares. And I did a blue card base because I thought, oh, it's kind of like the sky, kind of a pretty. This is our medium blue cardstock. And it's called Raindrop. So there we go. Yeah, kind of fresh and pretty on that blue. So now I can play with my lemons. I can kind of get them in here. Maybe before I start gluing down, though, let me add the little, put the stems inside these guys. I'm going to bring in my sentiments so I can make sure that all my elements are working together on my card. So I've got some lemons and some lemon blossoms. Now, those of you who know horticulture or know lemon trees kind of know that you really wouldn't have lemon blossoms at the same time you have lemons, but it actually does happen once in a while in Arizona, because sometimes our lemons are left on the tree so long because they just get riper and riper, and then by the time the new blossoms come, you might still have lemons from last season. But for my sentiment, I'm going to grab one of our also brand new die sets, or stamp and die combos. This is called Many Birthdays, and I love, love, love this stamp set. It has got exactly what it says, so many birthday greetings. The large words, happy and birthday, cut out with a coordinating die, which I love. You can pop them up. In fact, there's a card project on the back. You can see how cute, right? Oops, trying not to get it glary for Roy. This is, again, the bold blooms, which is also part of the collection. I'm sure you'll see lots of that inspiration online. And then here's the happy birthday. So cute. Embossed and then cut out with a matching die. But there's also tons of other birthday greetings on here. So I actually just grabbed this sweet little happy birthday, which I have right here, and just kept it real simple, stamped it in black ink, and I'm going to cut it out with a little circle die. I'm trying to remember if this die is from our essential circles. It might be. I'll use my spare tape I had here earlier. Just kind of center that on there. Actually, a little bit higher, right? There we go. Cut this little guy out. So I can have my nice, sweet, happy birthday. Actually, I have two birthdays of my kiddos in February. So kind of nice to have a little stock. I love actually creating birthday cards any time in January in particular, because I love to stock them up kind of for the whole year. All right, scooch my dies over. We are down to the last step here. All right, so you can see why I wanted the white behind, because with this really bold black and white, I need my lemons to really pop, right? Couple more foam dots here. I'm not gonna put foam dots up on these leaves because I think they might end up hanging over the edge of that stripe. So there's a method to my madness, right? Okay, so I'm gonna kind of angle it really sweet. I wanna make sure this fits in an envelope. So I'm gonna go like right there, put my first lemon down. And then I'm going to figure out my sentiment so I don't accidentally pop a lemon where it's not supposed to be. So I think I want this right around here, kind of in the bottom corner, right? Cute. Grab my second lemon. I may have to trim these stems down. We'll see. Yeah, I'll just trim this down a little bit. Then I will pop the second one in here. Kind of want it to look natural. Maybe it's coming out from that stem. There we go. And then my last one, I think I'm going to kind of overlap because, believe it or not, lemons kind of grow in somewhat of a cluster. So I'm going to kind of tuck this one in. Can come from behind the leaf, that's fine. Maybe not quite that much. There we go. Kind of overlapping, like we've got a very abundant bunch of lemons here. Now these little, like I said, maybe they're not always with the lemon blossom at the same time, but I think they're adorable. So I'm gonna pop a couple of these guys in. Trim it just a little bit. There's one little bloom. Definitely want a couple of these flowers, mainly because I want a place to put some gems. So we'll put a couple of these little bloomy blooms. You can see I'm adhering most everything with our Barely Arts glue. It's just a nice little easy way to pop your pieces on and kind of have that opportunity to do a little minor adjustment. I'm going to put a pair of these blooms here. Oops, my flower came off. Go back. I bumped it. And I think one more flower, because three is a good number, right? I'll put one up here. Oh my gosh, I'm loving it, how bright and cheerful it is. And I actually really love it with the black and white stripes, too. I'm a fan. All right, so in order to finish this with just a couple little accents, let me grab some gems here. Now, these gems are fairly new to our collection, too. They're called the Aura AB gems, and they're really pretty. They've got just a really nice little, I guess what you call Aurora Borealis. I'll see if we can get it in the camera here for Roy, maybe on the side view. They're, you know, look kind of golden yellow when you first look at them, either a gold or yellow, but then when you turn or twinkle them, look at that. Look how they just change to all the different colors. They just pick up so many different beautiful colors. Isn't that gorgeous? So that's why they are called AB in the title, which stands for Aurora Borealis. So fun. All right, so I'm gonna pick some, maybe not quite the tiniest ones, but I'll get the middle ones. And I love this color again, which has a little bit of a gold or yellow hue. Come back. And this color, again, is called Aura. I'll put one in each little flower. And do I need more? Do I need more, guys? I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, you could sprinkle a few here in this background here or there, but I actually think the three is pretty. Again, you've got that nice odd number that designers love. Kind of gives you that good balance on your card project. So, what do you think? Love it? You love the black and white stripes? Too bold? Not bold enough? Some of you might be gold, go bold. But you know what? I figure since the collection of all of these dies, again, at SpellbindersPaperArts.com, is called Be Bold, so this is the Be Bold collection, I thought, you know what? Might as well go bold. So I hope that you like this little Try Day Friday and that you adore this lemon zest die as much as I do. Again, check out the address below and you will see all of the brand new things in the Be Bold collection, plus a lot of other really great stuff that's launched too here at Spellbinders. Every month we've got something new launching, so it's a really exciting time around here. If you have any questions, we are going to put links in the description. Leave questions in the comments. We love hearing from you. We love that you share your creations, so consider doing that on our social media channels too. We really love communicating with you. So have a great weekend crafting. We will see you next Friday. And until next time, this is Kim from Spellbinders.